Cashing in on Dolly's generosity, a News 4 I-Team investigation finds what some are calling an abuse of the Imagination Library. Chief investigative reporter Jeremy Finley found people and businesses receiving Dolly's free books and then turning around and making a profit off them.
I never thought about being the book lady, the painted lady, yes.
The books are just like Dolly, funny, colorful, beloved. And because of the creation of her Imagination Library, they're also free.
We started right after he was born.
What'd you get?
Jennifer Edwards' son is among the more than 1 million children who've received the books. And when we told her what we'd uncovered of people and businesses getting the books for free and then making money off them, well, here's her message to those folks.
What is wrong with you? That's what I say to you.
I had no idea that that was really happening.
The CEO of the United Way in Nashville is equally as surprised. They run the Imagination Library in the city. We showed him how some people were selling the free books for outrageous prices for first-run editions.
Maybe let them know that this is something that, you know, really defeats the purpose of the program.
Despite the disclaimer on the Imagination Library website reading that the free books can't be sold for profit, and the books themselves stating they can't be sold, they are. We were able to purchase them on eBay, on Amazon, and in used bookstores, all clearly marked Dolly Parton's Imagination Library. In fact, we found McKay's Used Books in Nashville has rows of them for sale.
But it's not right, and that's what I would tell somebody who's selling it.
Despite the person wanting to charge $75 to $99 for a book that was at first free, most people are selling for what you'd expect to pay.
This is obviously a very beloved program in Tennessee. Were you aware that these books weren't supposed to be sold?
Not at all.
Devin Mart is a manager with an online used bookstore where we purchased one of the books on Amazon.
Shouldn't this have been flagged in some way in the system as something that shouldn't have been sold?
Definitely. And I guess kind of your question is, who should be the ones who flag that?
Mart says Amazon prohibits certain books from being sold, so it's unclear why this is happening.
And I'm going to make sure that it gets taken out of our system.
As for all the ones we purchased?
We were able to buy a good number of these books. We're going to just bring them back to you guys.
Thank you so much. Yeah, we're very grateful for that. And I'm grateful for you pointing this out to us, because I honestly wasn't on my radar.
Jeremy Finley for the News 4 I-Team.
In fact, the Imagination Library stresses that once you're finished with the books, donating them to charities like the United Way is probably the best way to go. McKay's bookstore did send us an email saying it is reevaluating its sales of the Imagination Library books.